अस्सलामु अलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम्स। वेलकम इन साइंस क्लास, इट्स वीक नंबर 3 एंड लेसन नंबर 2। एज यू नो स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट टाइम वी स्टार्टेड विद द टॉपिक कंटेजियस एंड नॉन कंटेजियस डिजीजेस एंड वी कवर्ड कंटेजियस डिजीजेस। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द नॉन कंटेजियस डिजीजेस एंड देयर कंपेरिजन एज वेल। Non-contagious diseases are also known as non-infectious diseases. These are non-contagious and non-spreadable diseases. So let's start with the definition of non-contagious diseases. A non-contagious disease, or we can use the abbreviation NCD, N for non, C for contagious and D for diseases, is a medical condition or disease which by definition is non-infectious and non-transmissible. You know very well that contagious diseases are the diseases which can spread from person to person. Non-contagious diseases are opposite to the contagious diseases. Non-contagious diseases may be chronic diseases of long duration and slow progression, or they may result in more rapid death. Some of the examples of the non-contagious diseases are diabetes, in other words you can say sugar, obesity, cancer, asthma, hypertension, blood pressure, and certain cardiovascular diseases or heart diseases. These diseases are non-spreadable. These diseases are non-infectious. What are the causes of non-contagious diseases? Number one cause is physical and inactivity. Whenever you move less and there is no exercise in your body. Alcohol use, unhealthy diet, imbalanced diet, and use of tobacco. Some of the causes of non-contagious diseases are listed here. Number one, or the major cause, is the change in the lifestyle and your eating habits. Environmental changes, allergy, malnutrition means there is a deficiency of nutrients in your diet, imbalanced diet, long-term illness, side effects of medicines, or maybe heredity, which is transferred from parents to children. Now the question arises, how we can prevent ourselves from these diseases? These diseases can be prevented by 3 ways. Number one, maintaining the proper diet, balanced nutrition, balanced diet, the diet which contains the maximum amount of proteins, nutrients, minerals, carbohydrates, etc. Doing regular exercise, you know very well, exercise is a necessity for our body. And number three is visiting doctors for regular body checkups, especially when you are feeling any sign or symptom of disease or illness in your body, consult your doctor immediately. Students, that was all about the non-contagious diseases. Now I would like to summarize my topic by comparing both the diseases. What is the difference between the contagious and non-contagious diseases? As I already told you that contagious diseases are also known as communicable diseases, and non-contagious diseases are also known as non-communicable diseases. So the difference, the big difference, is that communicable diseases or the contagious diseases are the diseases which can spread from one person to another. And the non-communicable diseases are the diseases which are not transmitted from one person to another. You can see the difference between contagious and non-contagious diseases on the basis of 4 categories. First is the meaning, or you can say the definition. One obvious difference between both the diseases is the spread. Communicable diseases are the diseases which can spread from person to person, and non-communicable diseases are the diseases which does not spread from person to any other person. Now the second difference is cause. What is the cause of communicable diseases or the contagious diseases? You read in the previous lesson. Contagious diseases are caused by the pathogens or the microorganisms, while the non-contagious diseases are due to the malnutrition, due to the changes in lifestyle, due to environment, or maybe some sort of allergy. No infectious agents, or you can say that the disease causing organisms. Contagious diseases are caused by bacteria and virus, while there is no infectious agent causing the non-contagious diseases. Examples of contagious diseases are tuberculosis, you can say TB, AIDS, typhoid, cholera, malaria. And the examples of non-contagious diseases are cancer, allergies, rickets, diabetes, kwashiorkor, and heart diseases, etc. After reading about contagious and non-contagious diseases, students, it's very necessary to know that how we can keep good health, how we can save ourselves from these diseases. It's very necessary nowadays. You know very well the prevailing condition of COVID-19. We should know that how we can save ourselves from that condition, how we can fight with that coronavirus. So the first thing which is very necessary is the balanced diet. Balanced diet make our body healthy and fit and make it able to fight against the diseases. Second thing, adequate sleep. We should take proper sleep at least of 8 hours. We should do exercise on regular basis. Avoid using personal items of infected persons such as towels, sheets, etc. Don't share any item of yourself or any other person. Trim your nails. As you know very well, the nails contain the germs which are transferred with the food and may cause illness. So personal hygiene, in other words, you can say that personal hygiene is very important nowadays. Avoid eating foods which are kept for a long time, uncovered, contaminated foods. So these are the things which, if we will adopt, we will save ourselves from the prevailing condition, and in future we can save ourselves from the diseases. Here is an activity, an interesting activity for you guys. What you people do, you will find out the 4 diseases of your own choice, and then you will find out some points about those diseases. What is the cause of that disease? Either this disease is infectious or non-infectious. Then prevention, how we can prevent ourselves from that disease, and then the treatment. You will choose any 4 diseases of your own choice. You do this work on a color sheet, and then you will attach that color sheet into your notebooks. It's time to announce your homework. Your homework is question: what are non-contagious diseases? How are they caused? Means you will write down the causes of these diseases in points. Give 5 examples of non-contagious diseases. You will write any 5 examples of non-contagious diseases in the form of the points. You will do this work in your notebooks, and you will draw the diagrams wherever you feel that the diagrams are necessary. Thank you so much. Students, take care of yourself and your families. Stay home, stay safe. Allah Hafiz.